Good morning, Facebook Live. This is Robin Kirby-Ghetto. Welcome to today. It is going to be an awesome day in the Lord. I am just so excited. As I made brief mention on Facebook, today will be about testimonies. It is amazing what God is doing. Just yesterday, each of my sons at different times during the day, Matthew in the morning, Christopher in the afternoon, sent me testimonies about what God is doing, and it's massive miracle breakthroughs that they've been waiting for years for. Hey, Mary Holt. Hey, Belle. God bless y'all. Thank you for joining in. And so today, I just want to encourage you. I reposted I Hear the Father Saying from May 7th on my wall, and in that particular I Hear the Father Saying on that date, I put that God will restore all that the cankerworm and the locust have eaten. Hey, Suzanne, God bless you. Hey, Margaret Holt, God bless y'all. Thank you for joining in. I love you. Thank you for being here. And let me put my glasses on again so I can see. There's Matt Singh. There's Dietra. God bless y'all. Thank you for joining in. And I'm going to go up here for a minute, or over here. Behind me is a man that is very possessed, and I pray for him when I walk around him. So he's now coming in the park, and I just want to make sure that I have shalom with this broadcast. Amen. And so I'm walking, and you're gonna, you know what, I'll just walk by the gardens too so y'all can see the gardens, because they're so pretty. And maybe I'll sit over here today. He's actually coming this way, so look at these gardens. Isn't that beautiful? Look, and look behind me right there. I mean, this is just so beautiful. They built this last year, and it is a community garden here in downtown Birmingham in the historic district. Okay, I think he's fixing to go. Let me show you these marigolds. Look at all of this stuff that's growing. Doesn't it look amazing? Okay. Now we get to move forward. So yesterday morning, Matthew called me with a testimony, and I have to give the praise report on that because it's absolutely phenomenal. This young man has had such issue in his self-image, and God has been doing a mighty work in him. And years ago, he had to get out of college because he was still in process over dealing with the issues of what bullying in middle school did to his self-image. And so, thank you, Jesus, we're on the other side of that. But there really had to be a miracle breakthrough to get him back in. And it was so amazing, because guess what? The miracle happened, and he got the favor of God, and he got back in school. He got back in school, and it was only the favor of God that even yesterday, when he found out the awesome news that this college has taken him in, when everything in the natural says that he shouldn't. But you know what? Mercy says that God is going to do a miracle. And that is what God's mercy does, is it does miracles. So for four years, this young man has been in the wilderness, and he has been so discouraged, and he has been so down and just in such a dark valley for so long, that finally this year, I knew it, God was going to do a miracle, and Matthew is back in college. Is that not amazing? So he starts this fall semester, so be praying for him. Now, if that wasn't enough, okay, then I get a message from Christopher, my oldest son. I have two sons. Christopher, my oldest son, where he and his wife, Miranda, have been in prayer for issues that they needed massive favor for 2 years that has been a massive wrestling where they have just needed a breakthrough. Okay, I'll just put it that way. God has come through. He messaged me yesterday afternoon, and it was an unforeseen miracle that they have been really contending for 2 years. 2 years. And all I could think of as God had before had me in Psalm 112 and Psalm 12, especially 112, seeing that the offspring that He's given me would be blessed. And I posted that scripture, all of that scripture last night in two posts on my wall. And all I could think about as I got ready for the night, as God said, Robin, Pentecost is coming. It is almost here. And He reminded me of how at the time of Pentecost, there always seems to be a miracle, miracles. And He wants me to bring this miracle to you. And for those of you who are on my wall, you saw the picture that I took of the creature. Okay, I'll just put it that way. It looks like a locust. And FYI, do your research. Some grasshoppers do turn into locusts, okay? But we work out in downtown Birmingham at about 4 a.m.-ish every morning. And I'm talking about in the heart of the city, in the big buildings, okay? Actually, it's in the Wells Fargo building. And it's right in the middle of downtown Birmingham. We get through with our workout, and right there by our vehicle is this big locust-looking thing. And again, grasshoppers do turn into locusts. And the difference between it, I looked it up today, and I never knew that a grasshopper could turn into a locust. That totally blew my mind. But the difference between them is really their wings. That is one of them, besides being a horned kind of insect, the biggest difference is their wings, because locusts have a greater strength of wings and they are able to fly long distances. And generally, if it's a grasshopper turning into a locust, they turn from green to brown. Is that not crazy? Well, of course, God brought to mind the May 7th, I hear the Father saying, where I put, God will restore all that the cankerworm and the locusts have eaten. And He reminded me of this testimony today that He wants me to share with you, because you have no idea what your faith can do. And if you saw the post that I put up yesterday from the excerpt from my book, it is about that the evidence of your faith is in your commitment. Whatever you're committed to reveals your thoughts, your belief. It reveals your emotions, your thoughts and your emotions. And it's the mind and body connection. Romans 12:1, consecrate the body. Romans 12:2, have a transformed mind. And your mind and body, as I've been saying for over a year now, because I've been writing on this book for over a year and a half, and I have been talking about initially how 24/7 your mind and body are trying to reconcile 24/7. For those of y'all who have seen my Facebook Live teachings, for those of you who are in my group coaching, you've heard it a gazillion times. You've seen some of my excerpts from my book. Your mind and body are trying to reconcile and land on the same page. A good example would be rolling dice and you're trying to get doubles. And that's a good indication of what your mind and body are trying to do. They're trying to land on the same page, because your mind goes by thoughts and your body goes by emotions, which is actually subconscious thoughts. Your mind is telling you what your condition is, and your emotions are speaking to you subconscious thoughts that are unpacking and unfolding that are driving you, okay? So 24/7, you're trying to reconcile the mind and body. And this is the thing. That is what faith does. That is what hope does. Hope, the hope of Christ in us, the hope of truth, the hope of the Word, is bringing us into our destiny. It is causing us to enter the land of the living, the land of promise, that seventh day rest. Because in the natural, we wouldn't do things that look impossible, because it is totally risky. It looks like to some people that you're absolutely insane, you're crazy, But there is an intuitiveness in your spirit man, and Holy Spirit, through the still small voice of God, is speaking to your spirit man in your belly, where your second brain is, the second largest place of neurons in your gut. And you just feel an instinctiveness to do something that absolutely looks like it is impossible. And God is the God of the impossible. And it takes faith, like Abraham, to go into a land that you've never been in, to leave the place of familiarity, and to go into the place of the impossible. So watch this. In 2011, I knew I needed to get to a new school system because Matthew was now leaving that school that he was bullied at. And what's interesting is I posted the picture of his last day at that school today. It was in my memories, and I posted the picture of his last day there. Thank you, Jesus. You know, some of you need a last day picture. I want to get up and run. Do you hear that? Some of you need to take a snapshot of your today, and you need to call it your last day at this place. Picture, okay? And so in 2011, God put it on my heart. He said, Robin, you're going to move. Y'all are going to move and get Matthew in the Oak Mountain School District system in Birmingham Metro. And I knew that he was supposed to go to Oak Mountain. I absolutely knew it. And he would start high school there and give him a fresh beginning to somehow start working on a healing process within his soul. And so we went to look in the area. And this testimony is going to bless someone out there just to show you how big our God is. So we looked at homes in the area. And the home that I wanted, it was just way out of our price range. And I was looking to rent, and it was just way out of our price range. And I absolutely loved it. I absolutely loved it. And I kept passing it by, and I'm like, oh my goodness, that is like almost double what I'm willing to pay. Not quite, but almost, okay? Two-thirds above, almost double, two-thirds, just one-third right under double, okay? And so I just kept passing it by, and every time we would move to a new address, I would just see it as prophesying that season. And so I lived on a like Warrior Drive, Eagle Drive. I lived on Pilgrim Lane. And so we're moving to a new address, and all of a sudden we're getting a house to rent from a friend, and that house is at Sunny Meadows. And I looked at the house, and I said the same thing that I did at the house that was actually my dream house when I was still married to the doctor right before I became a single mother in 97. And I said to his stepmother when we were looking at the house that was my dream house back in 97, right before he left, and I said, I do not see myself at this house. And that was in Gunnersville, Alabama, where I was going to move to Gunnersville, Alabama from Birmingham. And I just didn't see myself there. And I told her, and sure enough, 2 months later, a month later, he left. And I knew that I didn't see myself at that house. I just couldn't see myself at that house. And it was the same thing in 2011. Rich and I got married in 2001. I was a single mother for 4.5 years. And Rich and I were going to move in 2011. And it was going to be the Sunny Meadows, and it was right close to Oak Mountain School. And I just kept going there, and I said, I know we're going to move here next week, but I just don't see me here. And it was within our price range where I felt comfortable. Well, would you know it, the husband and wife that owned that rental house were getting separated. So the husband calls me, and he says this. He says, Robin, you can't move into the house. So we've already given up our notice on moving out of the house that we're in, and we have a week before we have to be out. We have nowhere to move. And so watch God. And so I told that man, I said, listen, this is not good for us because we're going to be homeless in a week. But I knew that God had it. So this is what happened. He felt so bad. He said, I'm going to ask a friend of mine who's in real estate, and I'm going to ask him and look and try to help find your house. And guess what? I will help put $1,000 towards your deposit, because he felt so bad. And at the time, we really didn't have it to put because of all the other expenses with moving, all this other stuff. So this is what happens. He calls me back within 24 hours and he says, Robin, you're not going to believe this, but I called my friend, and he said that he and his wife have a house to rent. And I said, okay, where is it? And it turns out, and this is the weekend of Pentecost. This is the weekend of Pentecost, and I'm bringing all this up. It turns out that it was the house at Eagle Point Draw, at Eagle Point neighborhood, Eagle Park Road, the house that I had passed over two times because I thought we could not get it. Do you hear this? I passed over that house two times, and said we just can't get it, but my heart wanted it. Something in me leapt when I saw that house, and of course, Eagle Park in Eagle Point. Oh, that is totally my address, not Sunny Meadows. I could not reconcile Sunny Meadows to my body, okay? But as soon as I found Eagle Park at Eagle Point, one of the highest points there in the neighborhood, I said, that is my address. We did not have to have a credit check. We did not have to do an application. We walked in on Pentecost Sunday, 2011, and signed a contract on that house. And it was beyond what we thought. Listen, this was almost 3,000 square feet in one of the nicest neighborhoods in Inverness. And only God. And I'm telling you what God did for my youngest son yesterday morning. He keeps saying, Mom, it's a miracle. It is a miracle. It is a miracle. It is a miracle. And what my other son said yesterday afternoon, all I could think of is Psalm 112 and about how God is going to prosper us. He's going to prosper my offspring. He's going to prosper us. We're in the land of the living. And I'm telling you, there is a Joel 2, because Joel 2 is about Pentecost. And when I saw that creature by my car today, all I could think of is God will restore all that the cankerworm and the locust have eaten. Do you understand that, saints of God? And what's so funny is my ministry, Table It, for health and wellness, which covers spiritual, mental, emotional, occupational, environmental, relationships, everything. Okay, that's what health and wellness does. It's called Table It. Table It. And it is based on the scripture Joel 2:26, that you shall come and eat in plenty, and you shall be filled, you shall be satisfied. Not you shall be hungry, you shall be filled, you shall be satisfied, and you shall see the awesome works of God. And I am telling you, saints of God, there is something in the hour for His remnant, for people to walk in the wisdom of Joel 2:23 through 30. Where there is, your oil vats are full, your wine vats are full, your harvest is here, and guess what? The locust is gone. Woo! Does that not like fire you up? That is absolutely phenomenal what God is doing. And I'm telling you, saints, God wants me to encourage you. He wanted me to give you these testimonies so you can be encouraged. And you can believe God for the impossible. It is about the mind and the body connecting in agreement in the hope of truth. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you.